Good day, everybody. Welcome to I Am a Data Podcast with host Nathaniel Evans. Today's topic will be overcoming adversity and finding strength and resilience. I had one guest for today, which is Chris Baker, the owner of the podcast, Tell Me Your Story. He hasn't been able to get in at the moment. I'm waiting for him to get in. However, you know, like you say, the show don't stop. We continue to move on. We move according to our purpose, and we allow nothing to move us out of our path. And it's basically what I'm a Dad is about. I focus on leadership in the form of inner development, looking at who we are, what we are, where we have come from, and actually using those different methodologies that we actually experience to actually create a framework for our lives that we can actually rely on, you know, that we can depend on in our lives and that we can allow to keep us in a basically state of strength, right? We want to be able to be empowered by our path, you know, the things that we've been through, so we can continue to, you know, empower others as well. Excuse me, guys. I ate something early, which is weird. But yo, still waiting for my guest. Hope he could come in. But if not, I just basically, you know, continue the show. So the premise of this podcast is for people to tell their story, to be connected to who they are at all times, and really not to take themselves for granted. You may think that the things that you've been through is insignificant, that nobody's going to benefit from them, nobody's going to learn from them, but that's not true. There are people that's actually going through some of the things that you are going through in your life, people that actually need help and assistance to understand certain elements of life and how to navigate through different things. And guess what? You got that story. Because you actually been through it. You can actually show people different tactics that you actually use, you know, approach that you use to move yourself from one space to the next. This is really important. This is essential. So as we're growing, as we're in a space of growth, right, lock ourselves into our story. I was on a call today with a real phenomenal individual. And he was basically telling me that, you know, my story is a priceless story as well. You know, craft my story, create who I am according to my story, and put me out there the same way I put this podcast out there, right? Be clear and intentional about who you are and what you want to become in life. Right? There is no utopia. Utopia is actually you in real form, moving according to the form that you're supposed to move in and doing the things that you're supposed to do according to your purpose, according to your insights about life. And, you know, as you journey on this path of self-discovery and self-awareness, there's something mystical that actually starts taking place. You start realizing something that as you're moving, there are other things that's moving right alongside you, in front of you, behind you, right? And some of those things can actually prevent you from moving on a level that you're supposed to move on, right? You get yourself caught up in different realities. You know, you start taking on purposes of other people, journeys of other people. While you're on your journey trying to find yourself, other journeys, other paths actually going to come into your path. There's going to be a lot of intersection going on. Some of those are going to be good for you. And you know, I should get involved with that. I should actually start talking to this person. I should, you know, really invest some time and energy and see what these individuals are doing and how can I actually be of assistance. And some of these things are here to derail you, actually stop you on your tracks and what you're doing. You know, you might have this grandiose idea on actually how to create something, right? Maybe a small business or maybe a product, and you realize, yo, I don't got the capital for that. I don't have the resources to move myself forward according to this principle thought, according to this vision. How do I do this, right? And somebody posed a question to me the other day. I got to share it, man. They said, if you were in a situation where somebody you love, right, needed $5,000 for a surgery, and it had to take you 2 months to get this $5,000. What things would you put into place to accumulate this $5,000? What do you have right now in your entourage, right? In your archive, right? That you could pull out, right? That's going to allow you to generate this $5,000 to protect one of your loved ones. What would you do? Do you have a book idea? Do you have any products and services that you've been sitting on that you haven't moved? Are you a prolific writer? Can you write papers for students and things like that? Can you write papers for professors? Are you able to actually create curriculums or create courses or, you know, become a motivational speaker, right? What is it as far as, you know, entrepreneurism or even, you know, working for someone else that you would do to tap in to get this $5,000? Like, how would you be able to do it? But this is a life threatening thing, right? For you to move forward. How would you tap in and get this resource so you can move forward in your path? So he's saying, you know, instead of you focusing on, you know, I got to get this for my moms or my dad or my sister, focus on how you're going to get this $5,000 for you, right? What is it that's of a dire strait for your life that you're going to tap into, right? So you can move forward for you. What sacrifices are you willing to make for your own life? What challenges are you willing to go through in order for you to get to this space here? I really wish my guest would have showed up today because he has some very good concepts and, you know, a great journey that I wanted to share with y'all. But yeah, as I say, this life here, you know, sometimes it just moves the way it moves. And sometimes we get caught up in many different things as we're moving on our path. And if this is the case, you know, I'll make sure that this show is only going to be a half an hour. Because I'm going to stand here for a whole hour and speak. I'll speak for half an hour if my guest doesn't show up. But, you know, I want to be able to be clear with people on the journey that we take in life, right? This journey is phenomenal, right? This is not a quick fix journey, right? We're not just moving according to the different things that's just here. Good morning, Gwendolyn Cummings. It's basically great to meet you. Happy to have you aboard. And yes, let's have a conversation. You know, my guest didn't show up, but, you know, maybe Gwendolyn, if I send her my link, she could be my guest, right? And she could just pop in, right? Because, you know, we are both, oh, she's an MPA. Oh my gosh, she's an MPA from NCNY. I'm also an MPA for NCNY. This is my last semester right here. I'm done in December. So this is a great conversation to have. If Gwendolyn jumps in, I sent you the link, Gwendolyn. If you want to jump in real quick, let's have a conversation. That'd be awesome. I also do this at times too. And good morning to everyone, or good afternoon to anyone that stopped in according to your time zone. And I just want to be clear about something. This has to be clear. As we take our journey, right? Thank you. As we take our journey, right? Know this. There is no clear path. You can create any path you want in your mind, in your heart, in your soul. But it's not a clear path. It's not going to come out the way you perceive it. You know what I'm saying? The way you have basically orchestrated within yourself. No, there's some twists and turns, and many twists and turns through this process as you're trying to rediscover who you are, as you're locking yourself in to a new, basically, facet for life, a new reality for life, right? And as you're moving in this new reality for life, there's that old reality for life, too, that was back there, right? You got to realize that certain belief systems that you have created, value systems, principles, moral compasses, right, are also dictators when it comes to you moving in your path. If you don't see certain belief systems you created or certain things you created or even what people created for you, because it's easy to find yourself inside somebody else's box. They'll create realities for you that you didn't even know that you told them to create. You never even instructed them. So you know what? I need you to create this reality for me, and I want to make sure that I never come out the reality that you created for my life. That's what I want you to do. You'll never tell anyone that. But people in the world will actually do this. They'll create a reality and put you right inside that box. Right? And then how do you get out of that box? I don't know. Tell your story. Be honest and truthful about who you are. Be intentional about who you are. And as one of my great individuals that I like, you know, on LinkedIn, she would say, be unapologetic according to who you are. Right? We're learning on how to be who we need to be because we need to be that person. You can't be anything else for anyone in the world, especially if we're not for ourselves. We can constantly try to, you know, basically please the world with who we are. We can give the world all our strength and all our power, right? But for some reason, right, things are not going to work out the way that we want them to work out if we're not tapping into who we are, right? So it must have been a misunderstanding with me and Chris Baker. We'll try to create another podcast later on down the line. So for now, it's actually moving according to your real time and according to your real spirit. And not allowing yourself to be dictated or overwhelmed by anything that's not going to increase you in the world. This is really essential. That you make sure that all the things that you connect yourself to is for your increasement, for your development, and for your awareness, right? This is how we move, right? And my guest said he will be on in a few minutes, so I'm gonna wait for him. But in the meantime, like I said, taking this journey, how do you take this journey? How do you do it? How do you start from scratch in your life? You might go through a divorce. You might have lost a lot of money, maybe even power that you lost. You know, you may have even lost certain realities about yourself, certain gifts that you had that you took for granted, right? So how do you springboard back from that? How do you let yourself know that you have value? And that you have purpose. How do you do it? How do you increase yourself knowing that you're in a space where it's like, you know what? Wow, man, I wish I wasn't here. I wish I could have did more with my life, right? And things of that nature, right? How do you do it? How do you get past your own past, right? In order for you to be able to find a sustainable future for yourself. How do you do it? I like to know, you know, put some comments in there, give me some thumbs up, you know, let's talk about it. Let's have a real conversation. Like we don't want to hide behind any center blocks. We don't want to hide behind the mirror. You know, we don't want to hide behind our makeup, or we don't want to hide behind our clothing or our new pair of shoes. We don't want to hide in our cars. Like we want to come out of all those things and actually be at the forefront of who we are. Actually putting ourselves through the microscope. How do we do that? How do we learn from who we are, from our own story? If you stood right now, if you had to stand in front of a mirror for 1 hour and just talk about who you are, will you be able to do it? For 1 hour straight, just talk about who you are, maybe even 5 minutes. Would 5 minutes be sufficient? Would 10 minutes be sufficient to tell who you are, right? Would you be able to think about that? Right, what Gwendolyn says. Hey, good afternoon, Maya. Always good to see you. Maya is one of my special guests who just popped in, you know, and has had an amazing conversation with Maya, right? And I know Maya for many years, and we always had a great relationship as far as, you know, helping each other, you know, see certain things and respecting each other's path as we're moving through the land, because there is no utopia, as I said before. Gwendolyn Cunning said, I think you tap into what you want and what you're good at. That's right. You tap into what you want and what you're good at But how do you do that without telling yourself your own story? If you negate your own story, what is inside your storybook? When I open your book up, what I'm going to find inside your book? You know, I might pick this book up right here. This book is, you may see it, Olivia E. Baker, right? Olivia E. Butler, right? So I might open this book up and it says The Paradise of the Sower, right? You know, the parable of the sower. I'm sorry, the parable of the sower. So now when I open this up, right, there's words in here. There's a lot of words in this book, right? If this was your book and this book was just plain, nothing in here, like a journal, what would your book say about you? You know, what would it do? What would Maya say? Let's see what Maya's talking about, right? I need 24 hours to unpack all of me, LOL. Oh man, 24 hours. Like you're gonna be rambling through the closet. You're gonna be throwing out old things. You know what I'm saying? Say, oh my God, look what I found. I didn't even know that was there. Right? You're gonna be. You gotta tell people to move out the way. You might step on this right here. It's priceless, right? You know. But at the end of the day, I believe it's one of the most beautiful gifts that you can give yourself. Is to be able to tap back in and learn about that value of who you are as a person. You can't leave you on the table. You cannot be the only mystery in the world. Like, you know everybody's business, right? And like I got one of my colleagues, he know, if you say something about history, he know everything about history. You can say this, oh, I know about that. It happened in this time period, and it happened in that time period, right? Yeah, that's great. That's great to know this information. But are you able to decipher and break down yourself in the same form and fashion? You may know how to put a BMW together from scratch, but are you able to put yourself together from scratch? You might be able to go and create a business plan and accumulate millions of dollars for other people, but are you able to create a business plan and create millions of dollars for yourself? You might be a life coach and help other people, right, get to the fundamental principles of their lives, right? Are you able to be the life coach for yourself and give you those same principles for your life? Let's say if you were to slip and you was to fall. Maya said it. I'm not going to say it. I'm going to let Maya say it to you, right? Yeah. You need strength, courage, wisdom, and resilience to keep it intact for your life. Know all things if you want to know all things, but I don't want to know all things. There's too many things in the world for me to know. I don't need to know all the things. I don't need to know the things that I need to know, like Henry Ford said, right? I need to know the things I need to know, and the only way I can do it if I don't know those things is get the people that know what I need to know. I'm not going to run around here trying to know every fish name in the sea. That's too much time and energy. I don't need that. That's not even my path. That's not even my profession. I don't even want to know about that, right? What I do want to know is what makes Nathaniel Nathaniel? What makes Gwendolyn Gwendolyn? What makes Maya Maya? What is this? What is this secret potion that you have? This phenomenal potion, this phenomenal energy, this phenomenal substance that sometimes it might just be sitting on the table waiting for you to pick it up and say, hey, man, this is inside my book. This is my life story. People have created life stories for me. But it's not mine. People have actually said, hey, you know, this is who Nathaniel is. This is what Nathaniel represents. This is what Nathaniel is about. And I'm saying, well, I didn't give you permission to define who I am. I didn't give you permission to characterize me and make me into what you want me to be. I didn't do that. And because I didn't give you permission to do that, and even if you did it, I have to take back my power. I have to know that I have the right and the final say-so to define my life. No one else is going to do it for me. And I've been there. I've been around men and women that say they were phenomenal in the world, that say that they was leaders. I've been around these type of men and women before. I also remember that I even took slips and falls around these men and women before. They didn't reposition me. They didn't come back and say, Nathan, you forgot who you were. You forgot what you're supposed to be. You forgot your path. Come and sit down with us and have a little breakfast, a lunch, or dinner, so I can help you, Nathaniel, re-strategize and restructure who you are and get yourself back into a principled thought, you know what I'm saying, of being who you're supposed to be according to your path and your purpose, right? Who does that for you? If you find one person in the world that see you fall and do everything in their power to put you back together, woo-wee, you are blessed. You have found a blessing beyond blessings in the world, and you don't even know it. And I'm telling you, if you find that one person, don't take that person for granted. Lock that person in. That person is your lock and key. That person is your safety net. I read this old parable many years ago, and I'm basically still reveling today. It says that, you know, it's about the Lord. It says, tells the Most High, you know, I'm on my journey, but if I ever get tired from walking my journey, can you please pick me up and carry me the rest of the way, right? Will you find men and women in the world that's going to carry you the rest of the way? Maya says, the desire to live and love one another as the Most High intended us to do. Oh my God. Yes, she's true. She's true. Right? We are intended to love each other, to empower each other, and to want for others the same gifts that we want for ourselves. This is purposeful. This is intentional. And this is according to free will. Look at it. Who's going to feed you when you get hungry? Who's going to give you drink when you get thirsty? Who's going to clothe you if you wind up having a house fire? You know what I'm saying? Have no more children, don't have no more clothes. Who's going to do it? Who's going to do principal things for you in your life? And you can find no one in the world. You can think about no one in the world. That means something. That means that you have to do these things for yourself first and foremost, regardless of what you have, you know what I mean, in your corner in life. You are the principal of your life. You are the principal of your thoughts. You have to instill high qualities and substance in who you are. And no one's going to do it. I've been around for a long time. You know, if you speak to a life coach, yeah, you may say, yeah, I'm here to help you grow and I help you build. Yeah, okay. But this is at a fee, right? They say if you give away something for free, people don't value it. That's amazing. That's amazing that if you give something away for free that people don't value it, because when I was young, it used to be pear trees and apple trees and banana trees. And I used to go there every day and get a pear and an apple, because it's nutriment to my life. Not because it was free, not because it was in the land, you know, it doesn't mean anything because it's free. No. It's a substance for me, whether you say it's free or not, right? That apple, that pear, that banana was a value to me when I was growing up. Because when I got hungry, I knew where those trees was at in my community in Brooklyn. I knew where to find those trees and go climb a tree and get me a couple of fruits and and take them home. Or sit in the park with my friends, say, hey guys, I found like 10 bananas. Hey guys, let's eat some bananas real quick, right? So this is important that you have to find the substance in the world to keep you intact, to keep you afloat. Hey guys, my guest showed up, you know, my guest finally showed up. I was on a roll. You got to take over now, right? So guys, this is Chris Baker, you know, the owner of Tell Me Your Story podcast. You can find him on YouTube and other platforms like Facebook, TikTok, Instagram. He's out there like me. We wanted to collaborate with each other because we know that we have a principal strength in collaboration with each other. Right? We could do more together than we can actually do separately. But, you know, Chris walked on his path. Chris actually interviewed me, I was like 8 months ago. Now, when I was coming into my awareness, and Chris was like, Nathaniel, I see you, Nathaniel. What you doing, bro? What's going on with you? And I'm like, yeah, I'm hitting the surface, man. I'm hitting the ground running. And Chris like, no, let me help you. Let me come in. Tell your story, man. Redefine who you are. Let the world see it. And, you know, you might say something about your story, but maybe a little off, but now you could go back and look at it and say, oh, wow, man, I can reevaluate my life. And Chris actually helped me with that. Chris actually helped me as I was growing. Yeah, definitely, man. So tell them who you are, Chris, man. You know, speak your truth. We got 35 more minutes, so here you go, man. Speak your truth. Hey. Awesome. That's an honor. That's an honor. Isn't that something? Isn't that how life goes? Yeah. Yeah. And Maya said something real quick because I was actually speaking. And Gwendolyn said, nice to meet you, Chris. But Maya said something. I was talking about who will build you back up in the world if you was a four. And Maya made a great point. She said, nah, who will? What will feed you, clothe you? It's love. Right? And I think love for self is a phenomenal gift to be able to tell your story. And the topic today is overcoming adversity and finding strength and resilience. Let's talk about that, Chris. No, I mean, the topic is overcoming adversity and finding strength and resilience. You know, you have interviewed many people to tell their story. And what have you found according to this topic right here? What have you found amongst people? What's some silver linings that you have been able to basically isolate to allow you to continue on with your path on this podcast? Talk about that. That's right. That's it. Yeah. That's basically a powerful notion that, you know, yeah, definitely. I actually agree with that 100%. I also run into people who may not believe in, you know, my higher power or the higher power that I believe in, you know, the spiritual context of the world. And it's like, you know, sometimes I stumble with that, but I get to see that life has many different variations to it, and I'm okay with that, right? And so how do we help those individuals that do not have, you know, this belief system, are not able to, you know, tap into that higher source of being that you and I have actually found in the world, you know, through grace and through mercy, through compassion, through long suffering? We didn't bring these things to ourselves. These things came to us, maybe for some of the things that we did in life, you know what I'm saying? Maybe because some of the things that happen to us in life, that these things come and find us and pull us out of these dark spaces to tell us that, man, yo, man, you're great in that. You can do more things in your life, man, than what you've been doing. You can tap in, you know, the people that don't have this. How do we help them? You know, how do we get them? Yeah, because you like, would you do you run? Do you run from negativity or do you embrace it? Right? Do you run to positivity? You know what I'm saying? Or do you embrace it? Like, what do? Do you flee from things? I have people that I speak to on a positive level, and they be like, "I got to get away from this guy. I'm not trying to hear that. You know, you're just talking so much mumbo jumbo. You know, and I'm not in that life right now. You know what I'm saying? Right now, I'm in a whole nother space, right? And I'd be like, all right, man, you know, I'm not trying to offend you with my positivity. You know, I just think that life moves greater in the form of positivity. But you know, I cannot create the reality of others. Like you said, they have to create their own realities, overcome adversity and find the strength and resilience is basically what we do when we tell our stories to ourselves. We look at ourselves, we put ourselves on the chopping block, and we say, oh man, this is me, but I don't like that. You know, I don't like what I see, man. Or, you know, I like that. You know, that really resonates with me, right? And it's about, you know, being intentional, I would say, about your life and understand that has great value. Now, you want to be around people who's going to motivate you, challenge you, right? Push you in spaces that you say, man, I don't want to be there, right? And it's like, no. Let's see this together. You know what I'm saying? Let's look at this because, you know, I say I'm your friend, right? So I'm your friend. I'm not going to tell you things that's going to keep you basically in a bottleneck. I'm going to help you basically come out of these different chains and whatever circumstance that you actually found yourself in because we all going to find ourselves in circumstances in life. You know, right now it's 2023. You don't know what's in store for you in 2030. You don't got a clue. Me. Yeah, let's go. Yeah. That's correct. Yeah, I might ask you to put that book up there. You said Norman, I don't know what his last name is. Vincent Peale. PEELE, right? Yeah, and I also put the link up there just in case people want to actually look at this book. Yeah. Did you see what Gwendolyn said to your statement? You can read that. Right. That's right. Yeah, the willingness to, yeah, faith in yourself, the willingness to let go of everyone and everything is the strength required to overcome adversity, which results in resilience, right? You know, we are not the only ones in the world that seeks truth, you know, that seeks to actually see the fundamental values of life. There are others out here like Maya, you know what I'm saying, like Gwendolyn and others that's, that haven't seen this podcast, that they are actually all vessels of truth. They are vessels of faith, of hope, of mercy, of compassion, of charity. We all are these things that we seek in the world. We are also connected to those things. Those things actually resonate through us, right? We could become these different things in the world. We don't have to wait for this to happen or that to happen. You know, we speak about Christ. Yes, we speak about Christ, because Christ's name is also the anointed, right? We could also be the anointed also in the world, and we can anoint other people in the world just like the apostles. People had so much faith with the apostles that they had an ailment and they saw the shadow of the apostles and said, if I could just get to the shadow, I'd be healed. Like, I'm not even trying to get to the man. I'm just trying to get to the shadow of the man. If I can get into the space of the shadow of the man, I could be healed of this ailment. This is powerful faith, right? This is a faith that you need to put for your life, right? You the shadow for your life. Chase after you. Get to you. Get to the chicken, like they say, right? You know? Understanding your true value and having a true purpose for your life is phenomenal. And once you get to this space, who can take it from you? Who can do it? Right? Only you. Only you. I was on the train the other day. You know, I don't like to tell my business all the time, but I was on the train yesterday. Just yesterday, I was on the train. And wow, you know, I seen it was a. You know, a black man was with a white woman. They was together. They came on a train. They started antagonizing another white man for no reason. The black man was like, "Yo, I'm gonna take your life. I'm gonna take your life." He kept telling the white man that. The white man like, "Yo, I don't want no problems, man. I just want to enjoy my day and enjoy my life. I just want to be able to get off this train and go to my loved ones and stuff like that." And the man was threatening for his life because the man seemed like he was adamant, and he was telling him, "You know, if you don't get up next stop, you're never going to get off the train again." And I'm sitting here like, whoa, this is phenomenal. And he was with the white woman, and him and the white woman, they both had their energy against the man. The man was able to get off the train. And I was sitting there like probably like 2 minutes after the man got off the train, the white guy slapped the white woman for no reason that he was with. And I was like, whoa. And I just, I was like, I said, you know, when you coming into your space and you coming into your life, you got all these different things that's coming to you. All these different things to try to pull you out of your space. Your spirit will get threatened. People try to challenge you. You know what I'm saying? You know, you'll be exposed to realities that you never was exposed to. I remember I read a book on Eckhart Tolle, and I have that book. And Eckhart Tolle was saying that when you go in space sometimes, you got to put a spiritual barrier over who you are. You got to constantly say, "All right, protect myself." And then this entity or whoever you are is going to come at the forefront to protect you from all these different entities that's actually trying to come and invade you, try to come and overtake you, you know what I'm saying? And disempower you, right? And I saw that and I'm like, you know, according to social norm, I put the jumped up and fought the man. And I was like, no, mind your business. My spirit was like, mind your business, because this man and this woman were actually antagonizing this other man to the point where they even threatened a man's life. And because that, and I looked at it, I said, because the man didn't have the way to put the energy that he stored up, all this negative energy that he stored up, he didn't have the way to dump it because the man got off the train and nobody else was entertaining it. So who did he give it to? The person that was next to him. Oh my God. It stops you in your tracks. It stops you in your tracks, man. Yeah, it is easier said than done. Yeah, that's true. It is easier said than done, but at the end of the day, it can be done. It's not impossible, right? You have to be willing to go through the challenges and go through the different changes that you need to go through to find yourself on the other side of whatever that spectrum was, right? There are many different realities and hemispheres that's out here that you can step into and sometimes never return. Because I've lost a lot of brothers. Mentally, spiritually, in the world that I love, and I never got them back because the world was able to overtake them and disempower them and strip them of their essence. And this is one of the things why I even created Amidata, because I want individuals to know that, listen, look at my fall, look at the things that I've been through, the challenges I've been through, my highs and my lows, right? And learn from those things. Learn from those things. I'm not trying to create you. We don't want no carbon copy Nathaniel, because there's only one Nathaniel. But I can actually share some of the gifts of Nathaniel, right? Just like Maya shared the book, The Law of Divine Compensation, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, by Marianne Ann Williams. She also, Maya, I know you was a singer, right? But it says, if I could touch the hem of his garment, I would be made whole, right? That's what the song says. And this was Christ. That's the time of Christ, the time, with the 12 apostles, right? And being armed in our full armor. Yeah, you got to know that you have the right to put up force fields around you and protect you from the things that's taking place in the world. And you don't got to be subjected to these different things and moved by different concepts and realities that people say that you must follow because you're a part of this or you're a part of those different societies. When you see entities in the world that's causing strife and that's willfully causing strife, it is not your business to get involved with that type of strife and lose your life as a result. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, because I've learned something, in my transitions in life is when you're able to spiritually mind your business about certain things, you're able to conjure up the spirit of you and keep you fully armed, right? Ready to take on the world for the problems that come to you for you, for the situations that's come to you, for the enlightenments. You build yourself up. Now you can receive certain gifts. You can walk into certain rooms. You can meet certain people because now you have basically instilled yourself and empowered yourself to move to the next level. Right? And Gwendolyn, I'm happy that you stopped by, Gwendolyn. This is for all of us. Nathaniel, Chris, and Maya, this was a very enlightening, interesting conversation. My break is over, unfortunately. I have to leave. Daniel, maybe I'll see you at the MCNY event on Wednesday. I most likely will be there. Have a great rest of your show. Please message me the next time you have a live. I'll be happy to be a part of the conversation. And I'm definitely going to have you on my list. I want to reach out to you. Yeah, definitely watch it because she's also doing an MPA and I'm doing an MPA at the same college. I'm at basically end of my rope. And it's always good to see different airlights and, understand that we have the power to basically change, our lives. Yeah, that was great. Yeah. Wow, Chris, I've been waiting to talk with for a couple of days, to really increase who we are as people, and knowing that, we actually have the fortitude, right, to make the difference, not only in our life by telling our stories, but also by telling the stories of one another, by being involved in the storytelling process of one another. You come from scriptures, I come from scriptures as well. you know, maybe different realities of it, but it's a scripture that I really, you know, hold dear to my heart, which is Matthew 25:25, when he's talking about the sheep and the goat, right? That's something that really shows me when he was like, you know what? You ain't come see me when I was in a hospital. You ain't come see me when I was in prison. You ain't come see me when I was hungry. You ain't come see me when I was thirsty. You ain't come see me when I was injured. You know what I mean? Like, what kind of friend are you? What kind of friend are you? That you ain't come find me in the land and basically restore me and reposition me and create me to be a higher plateau. You want to be a higher plateau than me? Really? You don't want to be on the same level that I'm on? We can't work in sync and unification. You got to be greater than me? For what reason? What is the reason? Right? And when you look into this, yeah, Chris. Yeah. Yeah, I can sing too. Me and Mike might have to do a demo. Might do a demo or something like that. But yeah, that's a great energy, Maya. You know, because this comes with, this is a tool of self-preservation. You have stored up some great energy throughout your day. When you wake up in the morning and you start singing and meditating and worshiping, this is positive energy, raw, uncut energy that you're putting back into your being. And you know, the funny thing, as you move through the land, some of that energy jumps off. It jumps off you. It jumps to other people. You know, people say, hey, good morning. You know, yeah, it's just these different things, you know. People might come to you and just start asking you a general question because they see an energy that's on you that they're not familiar with. And they might say, damn, you know, Maya, what's this lady here? I gotta talk to her. Right? I gotta find out. What is her secret? You know, what is his secret? You know, why they have a great vibration and the world is in so much turmoil? Why they at peace? You know, why they able to tap in to the core of who they are and I'm not able to do it? I need to know their secret, right? And you wanted to, there you go. Tell them the secret. Yeah, I told her, yeah, that's right. I take walks too. That's right. Take on the world. That's right. Let me get some of that, man. Let me get some of that, bro. You know, because, you know, I'm hungry, man, and I want to feed not just. That's my stomach, not just my eyes, you know, but my spirit, bro, the life of me. I want to feed that. How do I feed that? You know, well, how, you know, what pool do I jump into that's going to bathe me and basically cleanse me, you know what I'm saying, and allow me to be anew, right? How do I get to those different things, right? There are things in the universe that helps us, like the trees, you know. The trees not only giving off carbon dioxide, but the trees also, you know, is an energy source. So like if I'm feeling down, I could just run up on the tree and hug the tree and say, yo, man, give me some of your energy, man. You in the world, you taking all this energy in the world. I need some of that right now, man, right? Let me get some of that, man. Let me get this tree right here, man, you know? Let me take a walk through the cemetery, right? And see all the lives that was here and all the lives that was gone and all the lives they had dreams and visions, you know, aspirations. Someone was able to achieve it and others wasn't, right? We get to see different lifespans. Somebody might have lived for 5 years, 10 years. Somebody might even live for 130 years. But we get to see the different elements and translations of life when we walk through places like that. When we go talk to elders in the street about life and things of that nature, we get to see different realities that we never foresaw before, right? Yeah, and create some new things. I know you. Yeah. got to make that decision yourself. So you got to make, you got to, and I think about, you know, being vulnerable, right? Allowing yourself to be vulnerable to you, right? Stripping off all the old layers, all the old concepts, belief systems, value system, stripping those things off, man, moving those things out your way. So now you get a clear vision about who you really are and what's really going on with you, right? Is your foot firmly planted in the spaces that you want to go? Is your, are you firmly planted to the point where if a strong wind comes, it won't just knock you, you know what I'm saying, off to the side? Will you be able to take the power of that wind or even walk against that wind to get to where you got to get to? Or are you going to say it's too windy outside and I'm not going out there? What are you going to say? Wow. Say that one more time, Chris. Yeah, man. You know, it's really important, you know, and I just did chills through my body because I'm really involved with my processes when I'm on these podcasts. This is me in real, true form. This is not a makeup contest. We're not doing no acting skits over here. This is live, right? And, you know, it resonates with me that, you know, be you, right? Be you and make you a part of you, right? Learn from your mistakes, from your achievements, you know, from your losses, from your gains. Put these things on you like the armor of God. You know what I'm saying? Walk with you, you are at all times and every element, and don't allow nothing to actually strip you to be who you want to be in the world and what you want to be in the world. Put it right here so it won't be moved. Most High says, store up your blessings in heaven so no man can rob and steal them and they won't turn into rust. And when you want to go get them, you know where they at. They here. Your blessings is with you. They blessings with the Most High. They stored up for you. And a heavenly being. Now, heaven is basically our higher essence of elevation, right? Our Lord, you know what I'm saying? That's on our higher level of elevation. That's telling you, yo, you can elevate right with me. We can elevate together. We can do some things together. Let me help you work some magic out here, man. You know, they say it can't be done. It can be done. Give it to them. How about this statement right here? How about this statement right here that Maya put up there? What you think about this? That's a, woo, that's the question of the day, right? You know, it's, yeah. You gotta ask yourself that question and ask yourself that question every single day. Am I at peace? If I die today, will I be at peace? Will I rest? Or will I be on one of those ghost stories that they got up there on YouTube? You know what I'm saying? See me sneaking out the bathroom, right? would that be me, right? Or will I be able to transition past this state and get to my next plane so I could be at peace? And so it's time for me to wake up on a higher plane that I need to wake up on, right? Will I be able to bring this type of substance into my life? How do I talk life into me, right? You know, how do I do it? Yeah, speak your life into the world. You know, be a part of who you are at all times. You know, go into the world. I was looking at a podcast the other day because I basically support other podcasts. I support other leaders that's out there. And the podcast guy said that, you know, for 30 days, go outside for 30 days and just say to yourself, I'm a spiritual being, right, living out a human experience. And then pay attention to all the different realities of who you are and what's around you and how they resonate with you, what resonates with you, what doesn't resonate with you, right? What's for you in the world, what's not for you in the world. And he said within 30 days, your whole psyche is going to shift. And you're going to be a whole new creature in the world. You know what those concepts are. You'll be a whole new creature, a whole new being, because you have given yourself the opportunity to fall in love with life as life has fallen in love with you. Life brought you forth into the world. Why wouldn't you want to be a part of what brought you forth into the world? And connect yourself to the life of you, because the life of you brought you into the world. You may think it's a coincidence. You might say, oh, my mother and father met at a club and there was a one-night stand. You can do all that if you want to. You know what I'm saying? But what you also can do is that and say, I'm intentionally here because I intentionally brought myself here to be here for a higher purpose and a higher value, and to be able to transition not only with myself, but also bring others with me on my journey of peace, of love, of happiness. You know what I'm saying? Also, maybe pain and suffering, to actually come out of that pain and suffering. It's like Christ said, you know, I didn't come for those that's healed. I came for those that was broken. Right? So if you're looking for a quick fix, utopian man and woman, don't do that, because we're not out here. There's no utopia man and woman. We're all broken in some way, form or fashion. And we all need to be put back together. Every so often, you might have a great energy for 3 years. Somebody got to come in the next 3 years and say, hey, man, let me get you back on track like Job. Right? Let's do these things with you. Let's sit with each other in the dirt for 7 days and seven nights and don't speak one word to each other, but give each other one another energy so we can keep each other afloat. Let's do some things like that. That's correct. Keep giving up. That's right. That's right. So, you know, you want to be able to tap in to others. You know, we about to end in a minute, you know, and I definitely want to reconnect again. You know, I want to give you your whole hour, you know, with a misunderstanding. So we want to be able to revisit this part two, right? If you're not busy next week, we'll do a part two, because I want you to get this full time, you know, because you have a lot of jewels and a lot of wisdom that people are going to need. And with that, I want you to maybe, you know, tell people who you are, where they can find you, what's going on with you. You know, I'm going to send this video to and everything so we can work our magic on these things. That's right. Reach out to Chris. That's right. Reach out to Chris. Tell that story. You know, you can't find him, find me, and I'll find Chris for you, right? So, you know, let's work together, you know, to do this. And welcome to I'm a Data. Our topic today was overcoming adversity and finding strength and resilience. Please subscribe, tap in, ask to be a guest on my show, Chris' show. You may even come together as a collaboration. let me say, to bring more insight and awareness about, you know, who we are and what we are and what we have to offer to one another, and to always keep each other at the forefront. And like I said, speak your life into the world. With that, great, great day, guys, and happy that you were here. Hold on, Chris.